A great feature of ARCHICAD 18 is that it comes with a wide range of surface materials built in. Here, for example, we have a bubble chair we will use in a project. As a first step, we need to assign appropriate surface materials to various parts of the chair. Most common surface materials are already available in every newly created project. If something is not part of the project, you simply search for it in the catalog, like in the case of leather that we need for the pillows. The bubble is made out of plexiglass, and this material is not part of the catalog. Instead, we'll modify an existing glass material in a way that suits our particular needs. With the brightness slider and transparency channel, the level of transparency of a given surface material can be adjusted. A plain glass material is almost 100% transparent. For the plexiglass, 85% will be enough. The refraction index of 1.55 is too high, so let's lower it to 1.49. The refractive index determines how much the light is bent, or refracted, when entering a material. For example, water has a refraction value of 1.33, while sapphire has a value of 1.77. Let's turn off the total internal reflection option. For further information, please check the ARCHICAD reference guide. We want a colored glass, therefore we set the color brightness to 100% and RGB values to 121, 52, and 6. We will change the specular color from white to something between orange and red. And use the following width and height values. Finally, let's set the diffuse falloff value under illumination options to -25%. And make a new render. Please note, during the setup of materials for the bubble chair, we hid everything possible from the scene, especially the additional light sources. The reason is very simple. Until you find the right setup of a surface material, you'll have to make at least 5 to 10 renders in order to find what you're looking for. The more complex your scene is, the render time will be longer and longer. Behind this glass wall, there will be a bathroom. Therefore, this transparent glass has to be changed to a frosted glass. We duplicate the surface material assigned to the glass wall as a first step. Then import a material from a Cinema 4D project. As there are plenty of parameters to set, we will show you each channel. Feel free to pause the video and copy the settings to your own material. Let's hit render to see the result.